that commemoration. You may notice this small table here in place of honor. It is set for one. This table is our way of symbolizing that members of our profession of arms are missing from our midst. They are commonly called POWs or MIAs. We call them brothers. They are unable to be with us this evening, and we so remember them. This table is set for one is small. It symbolizes the frailty of one prisoner against his oppressors. The tablecloth is white. It symbolizes the purity of their intentions to respond to their country's call to arms. The single rose displayed in a vase reminds us of the families and loved ones of our comrades in arms who keep faith awaiting their return. The ribbon tied so prominently on the vase is the reminiscence of the red ribbon worn on the lapel and the breast of thousands who bear witness to their unyielding determination to demand a proper accounting for our missing. A slice of lemon is on the bread plate to remind us of their bitter fate. Their assault upon the bread plate, the symbolic of the family's tears as they wait. The glass is inverted. They cannot toast with us tonight. The chair is empty. They are not here. Remember, all of you who serve with them and call them comrades, who depend on their might and aid and relied on them, for surely they have not forsaken you. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the invocation and remain standing for the presentation of color, followed by the national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, Cadet Corporal Sophia Soto.
Let us pray. Father, we thank you this special evening for our lives, our families, our liberties, our freedoms, and our Corps. Yet as we take these blessings for granted as a birthright, we remember that these things we now thank you for have come at a terrible cost. You have required that some of us substantiate for all of us time and again that we are worthy of these blessings you have bestowed upon us. We are here this evening because of the Marines who have gone before us. Many have unselfishly given their lives on the battlefields this nation has had to endure to ensure that we, at least, could continue on. Help us not to forget those who willingly sacrificed the miracle of life you gave them in order that we could continue to live free within your grace. Heavenly Father, let the spirits of these departed warriors walk among us tonight so that they will know that we fully comprehend and value their sacrifices. Give us the same courage and determination so that we will ensure that their lives given in the defense of our freedom will never have been given in vain. Amen.
Please welcome our guest of honor, Mr. Erick Mendoza, escorted by Cadet Captain Samantha Louie, Cadet Corps Commander of Selma High School Marine Corps Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps.
Honor Guard, present. Sword. Order. Sword. March on the colors.
Happy. Cool. Ready. Cool. Forward. Move.
Gentlemen, please be seated.
Thank you.
On November 1st, 1921, John A. Lejeune, 13th Commandant of the Marine Corps, directed that a reminder of the honorable service of the Corps be republished by every command to all Marines throughout the globe on the birthday of the Corps since that day. Marines have continued to distinguish themselves on many battlefields and foreign shores in war and peace. On this birthday of the Corps, therefore, in compliance with the will of the 13th Commandant, Article 38, United States Marine Corps Manual, edition of 1921, is republished as it follows.
On November 10, 1775, a Corps of Marines was created by a resolution of the Continental Congress. Since that date, many thousands of men have borne the name Marine. In memory of them, it is fitting that we who are Marines should commemorate the birthday of our Corps by calling to name the glories of its long and illustrious history. The record of our Corps is one which will bear comparison with that of the most famous military organizations in the world's history. During 90 of the 146 years of its existence, the Marine Corps has been in action against the nation's foes from the Battle of Trenton to Argonne. Marines have won foremost honors in war, and in the long eras of tranquility at home, generations after generations of Marines have grown great in war in both hemispheres and in every corner of the seven seas, that our country and its citizens might enjoy peace and security. In every battle and skirmish since the birth of our Corps, Marines have acquitted themselves in the greatest distinction, winning new honors on each occasion until the term Marine has come to signify all that is highest in military efficiency and soldierly virtue. This high name of distinction and soldierly repute, we who are Marines today have received from those who precede us in the Corps. With it, we also receive from them the eternal spirit which has animated our Corps from generation to generation and has been the distinguishing mark of the Marines in every age. So long as the spirit continues to flourish, Marines will be found equal to every emergency in the future as they have been in the past. And the men of our nation will regard us as worthy successors to the long line of illustrious men who have served as soldiers of the sea since the founding of the Corps.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The inspiring message of our 13th Commandant has left its mark in the hearts and minds of all Marines. Ladies and gentlemen, a message from the Commandant of the Marine Corps.
As we celebrate our 243rd birthday, Marines remain in combat, forward deployed throughout the world, confronting every challenge with courage, loyalty, and faithfulness. Each year on this day, we renew our resolve to be the most ready when the nation is least ready. We pay tribute to all who forge our proud legacy. We recommit ourselves to defending freedom anytime and anywhere. We stand ready to aid those devastated by natural disasters, and we honor the families and loved ones who faithfully stand beside us. This year marks a number of significant milestones. 100 years ago this June, a determined brigade of Marines fought ferociously over the hallowed grounds of Baloo Wood. Those Marines solidified our Corps' global reputation for being a tenacious and highly skilled fighting force that forever etched the phrase "Tupelhunted" in our lexicon. The same year, Marines secured control of Baloo Wood. More than 300 women answered our nation's call, becoming the first females to enlist in our Corps. The legacy of the first woman Marine reservist and all trailblazing Marines serves as a reminder that the title Marine is not restricted by gender, color, or creed. It is a warrior spirit and distinguished role earned by an elite group. This year also marks 50 years since Marines fought ferocious battles against a worthy foe in some of the most austere locations in Vietnam. The indomitable spirit and unyielding resourcefulness of Marines, cutting through the mountainous triple canopy jungles and overcoming the challenges of urban combat during the Tet Offensive, on the warfighting prowess of our Corps. Our lessons learned at Khe Sanh and Hue proved crucial to our successes during operations Enduring Freedom and Iraqi Freedom, allowing us to secure victory in the fields of Sangin and on the urban battlefields of Fulua.
It is also at Hue that now retired Sergeant Major John Hanley charged enemy machine gun positions and put his own life on the line to ensure no Marine was left behind, epitomizing the true meaning of Semper Fidelis. Today, we proudly honor his faithfulness with our nation's highest award for valor. For 243 years, Marines have fought and won whenever and wherever the nation calls. In the harshest conditions, over the most brutal terrain, and against the most formidable enemies, Marines defend the ideals of freedom with grit and tenacity. Through battlefields change and capabilities evolve, the story proves that true victory comes from the individual Marine with steeled resolve, the drive to overcome any obstacle, and the warrior spirit to fight against all odds. It takes that steadfast faithfulness, Semper Fidelis to Corps, country, and each other that abounds throughout our storied legacy. Happy birthday, Marines. I'm Robert B. Neller, General U.S. Marine Corps Commandant of the Marine Corps.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cadet Captain Samantha Louie and our guest of honor, Mr. Erick Mendoza. Ladies and gentlemen, traditionally, regardless of location, Marines pause to observe their birthday by sharing a cake. The Marine Corps birthday cake cutting ceremony is important to all Marines, as it is an annual renewal of each Marine's commitment to the Corps and freedom worldwide. The birthday cake is traditionally cut with the Mameluke sword as a reminder that we are a band of warriors committed to carrying the sword so that our nation may live in peace. The Mameluke gives its name from the cross hilt and ivory grip design, similar to those swords used for centuries by the Ottoman warriors. The Marine Corps tradition of carrying the sword dates from Lieutenant Presley O'Bannon's assault of Derna, Tripoli, in 1805, where he earned this award for the Prince Hamid, who was the Pasha of the Mamelukes. The first slice of cake is presented to our guest of honor, Mr. Erick Mendoza. Mr. Mendoza is a former Cadet Corps Commander of Selma High School Marine Corps Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps in its first year of existence in 1994. The second slice is given to the oldest and to the youngest cadet present. This tradition signifies the passing of honor and respect regarding to experience and seniority. The oldest cadet this evening is Cadet Private Karina Palacios, born on August 1st, 2000 in Fresno, California. The passing of the cake from the oldest to the youngest cadet symbolizes the passing of history and tradition to the next generation. The youngest cadet present is Cadet Private Oscar Herrera, who was born on November 23rd, 2004. Selma, California. This tradition further emphasizes the fact that we care for our young Marine cadets before we look to our own needs. And so it has and has been for 243 years.
Order! Cut! Ready? Clipping bar. Pull.
Honor Guard, present. Sword. Tire, the colors.
Cut them off. Pull.
Continue to celebrate this anniversary of our past and those who have fought their last great battle for our foreign country. In memory of fellow Marines who have made the supreme sacrifice and those who will follow in the future, please remain standing for the benediction. Ladies and gentlemen, a moment of silence for those who have gone before us.
Let us pray. Almighty Father, whose command is over all and whose love never fails, make me aware of thy presence and obedient to thy will. Keep me true to my best self, guarding me against dishonesty and purpose, and deed and helping me to live so that I can face my fellow Marines, my loved ones, and thee without shame or fear. Protect my family. Give me the will to do the work of a Marine and to accept my share of responsibilities with vigor and enthusiasm. Grant me the courage to be proficient in my daily performance. Keep me loyal and faithful to my superiors and to the duties my country and the Marine Corps has entrusted to me. Make me considerate of those committed to my leadership. Help me to wear my uniform with dignity and let it remind me daily of the traditions which I must uphold. If I am inclined to doubt, steady my faith. If I am tempted, make me strong to resist. If I should miss the mark, give me the courage to try again. Guide me in the light of truth and grant me wisdom by which I may understand the answer to my prayer. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Before we end the ceremony, the committee would like to thank some organizations that helped us put together for over the years. Louise Arroyo, Colorado, Daniel Lopez Hall. Rick Helm and staff, dinner. Angel, DJ. Newman Studios, Mr. Garcia, photos. Cakes by Joanne, birthday cake. Selma Floral Design, Laura. American Legion Post 12, and Garrett Beating Foundation. Please join me in a round of applause for their generous support. At this time, I would like to introduce our guest of honor. Mr. Mendoza was born on December 4, 1976 in Selma and raised in San Luis Obispo, California. He returned to Selma to be raised by his grandparents, Margaret and Donald James. Mr. James, a retired Sergeant Major, Sergeant First Class in the Army, had a major impact on the decision Mr. Mendoza would make moving forward in his young life. During his junior year at Selma High School, he would meet Major Hand, the first senior Marine instructor of Selma High School MCJROTC. Destined to become a Marine, Eric and fellow students, Tony Almendarez, Kimberly Paul, Eileen Martinez, Deanna Tiger, would become the first cadets of the program in 1994. As cadet captain in his first year, working with Major Hand and Master Sergeant Burkhardt, the first Marine instructor, they would start the foundation of our program's outstanding history and tradition. In his senior year, Cadet Major Mendoza would become the first Cadet Corps Commander of the program. During the end of his senior year, he petitioned Selma administrative staff to graduate in his dress blues. Mr. Mendoza's request was approved and is now a long-standing tradition with all seniors desiring to participate in the graduation wearing their dress blues. Upon graduation from high school, he enlisted in the United States Marine Corps in 1995 and was on track to graduate on November 10, 1995. Unfortunately, 3 weeks before graduation, this wouldn't come true and he would eventually graduate in January 1996 due to medical reasons. After completion of boot camp, he would become a communications center operator in 29 Palms. He would later ship out to Okinawa, Japan with the 3rd Marine Division. He was involved in operations in Australia, the Philippines, and South Korea. He would return to MCAS Miramar, where he would be discharged from active duty. He later re-enlisted into the Marine Corps Reserves, where he would be promoted to Staff Sergeant. During this time, he was mobilized in support of Operation Iraqi Freedom performing convoy security missions. In 2008, he decided to end his time in the Marine Corps and start his second career. Mr. Mendoza is now serving as Selma Unified School District's Director of Technology. He is currently happily married to his wife, Michelle, for 5 years and blessed with 2 beautiful girls, Melania Ray and Lotus Dawn. His decorations include Navy Marine Corps Commendation Medal, Navy Marine Corps Achievement Medal, Combat Action Ribbon, Navy Unit Commendation, Navy Meritorious Unit Commendation, Marine Corps Good Conduct Medal, Select Marine Corps Reserve Medal, National Defense Service Medal, Iraqi Campaign Medal, Global War on Terrorism Service Medal, Navy Sea Service Deployment Ribbon, and Armed Forces Reserve Medal. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Eric Mendoza.
Could we all please give a big round of applause to the cadets of Selma High School MCJROTC? They did an outstanding job this evening. And special recognition and thanks to First Sergeant Romero, Master Sergeant Burkhardt, old memories, for inviting me here today. I appreciate the honor. Oh, yes, big round of applause. Wow, I can't believe this is the 23rd Cadet Ball, is that right? Fourth? Okay, let's count. 24th Cadet Birthday Ball. It seemed like yesterday when I myself was out there running PT with Master Sergeant Burkhardt. And actually in the district office, you know, where I work in the district, where my office is located, I can actually hear you all having fun out there PTing with First Sergeant and Master Sergeant out there. And as a matter of fact, seeing the way my jacket's fitting tonight, I may have to jump the fence in a couple days and start running formation PT with y'all. Yeah, make it hurt. All right, I'd like to start by giving you a little more background information on me. It was the year 1994. I was a junior at Selma High School, coming off a low point in my educational career until I met Major Hand and Master Sergeant Burkhardt. As you may have read in my biography, my grandfather, a retired Army Sergeant First Class, was a major influence in my life. So when I met Major Hand, he was very, very relatable. I knew a little about the customs and courtesies of the armed forces, and needless to say, I was intrigued. Personally, at the time, I was not aware of the leadership potential that I possessed. I was a junior, basically, with no guidance and no future at that time. I lacked direction, I lacked focus, I did not know what my strengths were, and I had no idea what I was going to do going forward after graduation. That is the very first thing that the MCJROTC program taught me. Major Hand saw something in me that I did not, and that was potential. To this day, I am eternally grateful for him and Master Sergeant Burkhardt, for had it not been for their challenge to lead, I don't know where I would have been today. So now let's go back to the story of how it all began. Second semester, junior year, back in 1994, I, alongside with the brave students listed there in your program, took our first step into what is now a 24-year history, coming to school dressed in our camouflage utility uniform. Now, I imagine it's pretty normal nowadays, right? The staff and the faculty there at the high school are pretty much used to seeing cadets and kids walking around in their camis and sometimes in their dress uniform. But I want you just to kind of imagine how we felt. So going back to that, it was a feat that kind of took courage. And we all know that high school kids at times can be a little cruel when it comes to joking and making fun of people. So again, for myself and my fellow cadets, it was something that we took great pride in, to put that uniform and walk down the hall. I would like to say now, again, going back to how familiar it is for you and everybody else, I guess it would kind of equate to seeing three or four students walking down the high school in Selma, or walking down the hallway in Selma, and maybe, I don't know, full astronaut gear or something like that, right? It would kind of be out of the ordinary. So at that time, it was a great feat for us to be able to do that. So we carried on with pride as we get to learn what remains today, the customs and courtesies, discipline, respect, and courage that MCJROTC instills in us all. I'd like to highlight those two words, respect and courage. I know that some of you will graduate Selma High and choose to go on to college. Others may choose to go into the workforce. Some may enlist in the armed forces. I'm here to tell you that what you take away from MCJROTC will stay with you for the rest of your life. It stayed with me. Although trained in one MOS, I was fortunate to receive on-the-job training in the field that would send me on a prosperous journey, all leading to where I am today. I left active duty after 4 years to start a very successful IT career in Chicago, Illinois. The two things that kept me moving onward and upward in my career come back to what I learned right here in Selma, California, by way of being an MCJROTC cadet. Courage and respect. If you take these two things and carry them with you when you leave high school, I guarantee you will be successful in whatever it is you choose to do. Now, I have a wonderful opportunity that not many get to have. I am a leader giving back to the community that brought me up, and also, even more specifically, the school district where it all happened. Honor, courage, and commitment will take you a long way. I couldn't be happier where I am today, leading the way of change within educational technology for all the students within Selma Unified School District. My hope is that while I am here, and while you are here, while you're going to school, that I can inspire you to take what you have learned, and apply it to your future. Because ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you right now that you are all the future. And we couldn't be more proud of who you are today. So, in closing, I'd like to thank my lovely wife, Michelle, for laughing at my jokes when I was rehearsing them, and for getting me where I am today. And I'd like to thank you all for having me as a guest speaker. And last, as a side note, again, going back to one thing I want to emphasize before I close is I understand that at times it can be trying as a student to figure out what you're going to do with your life, right? I was there. I was with you. I was in Selma High School. I didn't know what I wanted to do. Again, I want to emphasize, take what you've learned here and apply it. With the way society is nowadays, you will stand out. Remain courageous, be respectful, hold on to those customs and courtesies that you have learned here, and I guarantee someone's going to notice you. You will move up. I promise you that. And on a more specific note, if any of you are interested in learning more about the field of technology or informational technology, by all means, please reach out to me. All right, let me be a resource for you while you're going through school, okay? Because I'm here to help. I want everyone to be a success, especially those of you who are in this program. So that's it for me. Semper Fi, and happy birthday, cadets. Hoorah!
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony. Dinner will be served shortly. Thank you.